another Downs girl missing. Jocelyn Wade and Lucy Cook both turned up drowned within 10 days of vanishing.
Far as we know, Kathy Calvert shared no social contacts with the other two.
This fella moves like a dart.
I didn't drag her out of the river just to put her in the system.
How long is she going to be staying?
At the minute she's fit to speak, I'll be the closest one listening.
There's a guy out there killing Down syndrome girls who's not quite as patient as you.
999, what's your emergency?
Oh, no!
Let it haunt you. But we're in. So focus.
If you wanna party, let's drink it up and party. We'll drink it up and party, let's drink it up.
That's good. That's a good
answer.
Maybe we'll go back into the matches.
Oh, don't you look ace in that dress?
Yeah, look at you. Very pretty.
No visual. Repeat, no visual of Jimmy Webb.
This is all bloody wedding. You can't have done a runner already.
Shelf life's almost up, Viv.
Getting looks.
I've got him. I've got him. Looks like he just snuck off for a quick consummation.
How many guests, Dinah?
At least 40.
Won't be easy to yank him out on his own wedding.
Yeah, if you start frying Asian beers with petrol, we wouldn't have to, would we?
Can you isolate him?
Negative. We need to make a decision. This isn't going to get any prettier.
Shit. Kerry Mandrake sent her down for spousal GBH.
We've been spotted.
Stall for 60 seconds.
Joy.
In 60 seconds, they'll have stomped our heads into the floor.
Come on, boys. All right, let me know if they're coming, yeah?
They're coming.
OK. Just follow my lead, all right? Hey! Massive congratulations, pal.
Both having a good time, yeah?
Yeah, great, yeah.
Amazing. This is Frank. I'm Vicky.
It's just me and the wife can't work out how we know you.
Well, you don't actually. We've just moved back from Australia.
Australia, yeah.
Kate, you said we could get crashed.
Is that all right?
Fucking cops!
Wait, back off! Back off!
Now, take it easy, right? You're going to regret anything you do.
Anything we do, we're not even going to remember.
Congratulations to Jimmy and Michelle from all of us at the Friday Street, Nick. Now, you two don't spoil a bear, do you? But what I'm really looking for is the father of the bride. Where are you, Vinny? Oh, now, Vinny, I'm only a little bit miffed not to get an invite to this little shindig after our family's history. Deerings have put every twig of your family tree in the clink. I'm so thrilled to be able to nip in the bud yet another union because your new son-in-law, Jimmy Webb, is what? Under arrest on suspicion of the murder of Samina Hassan. Come quietly!
Torture. I was on my stag night.
Yeah, but you went dark, didn't you, Jimmy? Just in time to nip off and get a few bits like petrol and matches.
So, onto the Down syndrome case. And I gather we have another promising lead, which you so graciously tested me at 4 a.m.
Oh, it's a bit more than promising, sir. Lucy Cook was a member of the Stage Wings drama company. They were devising a play at her day centre. Now, we tooth-combed her belongings and discovered this. A copy of the play, and on the front page, LC loves Captain Brown Bread. We're sending a detective to interview the group, keeping an eye out, of course, for anybody who matches up to Dr. Peeps. Criminal profile, which I'm sure you've all digested by now.
Ma'am, I'm not having a go, but...
It's a profile, it's not a 3D printer. Now, as for why, well, I'm afraid it can only be speculation at this stage, but For me, he picks these girls because of a severe sexual trauma, likely in his adolescence, which is why you'd be smart to do a search of any suspicious death of Down syndrome girls up to their early 20s.
We've already covered that, Doctor.
You covered the last 15 years. I'm telling you to do the last 50. And I'd hurry. The gap between Jocelyn Wade and Kathy Calvert's abduction is a massive acceleration. He's missed his fix. So he's agitated. Volatile.
I've designated our assignments. Connie's got printouts.
Move fast. Doctor's orders.
Wearing a skirt like that doesn't count if you score. You should be disqualified. I can't compete.
Shut up and keep your eyes off that rear view.
But he's still staying with you. I thought it was only supposed to be a few days.
Tell me about it.
How are you telling? Right, yours is the only place that we could play the volume at full tilt. Putin!
There are certain conversations that I can't have with him.
Like what?
Like any.
Oh, God, Jesus, Viv, you know, since one pass, I've cut right down on me carcinogens, but 24 hours cleaning this up might as well have sucked off a chimney. So, it's looking like your fire starter has poured petrol through the cat flap and whoosh. Cat survived, Joy. Poor kid, she's had zero warning. Organs too overdone to tell if the smoke got her first or the flames. It's tragic. It's fucking tragic.
Press conference in 5 minutes, ma'am. There's roadworks on Hadley Avenue. We're going to have to bomb it.
Choice of words, Joan.
Right, I'm going to need a plus one. Any volunteers? PC Ahmed.
My daughter-in-law saw the best in everyone, even the Manchester Metropolitan Police, despite the hardly surprising revelations of racism in the very marrow of their institution.
I know there's been talk of reprisals. Samina would not want any of us responding in kind to what they did to her. Anybody who knows anything, please, please tell us. Thank you.
We are doing laps around the clock to find who did this.
Blackmouthing us won't speed that up, innit?
I ring you lot 3 times a week when the shop gets vandalised. You don't even bother coming anymore. Yeah, so it's hard to be too thankful that you finally decided we're worth helping.
Clive, for your own safety, cease and desist, OK?
Oh, what are you, a nun now?
Come on, zip up all peculiar so I can ask you about the arson. Seriously, Clive, you're practically pissing on a grave.
I won't piss on that tight cow if she were on fire. Nicky! Your dick's still out.
Very good. Very good. Watch and copy every single movement the other's making like you're looking in a mirror. Adam. Adam, take this seriously.
All right, everybody. We've got a visitor. Detective Tanner's here to ask you a few more questions about Lucy.
It's Patrick. He did it.
Adam. Watch it. We discussed this.
He never listened. What noob?
How many times it was my stag do? I don't remember where I was at 3 a.m. Be a shit stag do if I did.
You're a known member of the British Democratic Action Force, and you've just married into the family founders of the movement. And, well, you've done this before. To her father-in-law's mosque.
Yeah. An empty mosque. Is this me? I want him out, not dead.
Then you're released from prison 1 week before this happens.
Exactly, so I wouldn't be so thick to get caught on camera, would I? We went to Half Moon's for some lap dances, then blackout. And if all you've got is some skinhead, then I'm laughing. And frankly, why would we bother going after one packet when there's 15 of them 5 doors down?
Shut your mouth!
Done.
Got this off Majid Hassan's phone. Clyde Bradley reckons he found it in the alley behind the house the night of the fire.
Right, and he was how pissed when he told you?
If Majid thinks we're questioning his statement, everything will go south. We just need to slip it in, simply, economically.
Wait, there's no point in dressing it up. We've every right to ask.
You've no idea how sensitive this culture can be.
Really? What about that time when me, you and Haddy went to that pub at Christmas and we ordered a mulled wine, but you giggled when Haddy ordered a Red Bull and a dessert? He dumped me for that.
No, he dumped me because he wouldn't give him a blowjob until he'd met your mum. After 2 dates.
I'm Detective Sergeant Joy Fries. My sincere condolences.
Can we just get on with it, please?
Get something.
Adam and Lucy were both in the Romeo and Juliet takeoff we did. Adam can get fiction and reality a bit confused.
Yeah, we found this on a copy of your script. Elsie loves Captain Brownbread. Mean anything to either of you?
No, sorry.
No. Lucy had loads of crushes, loved attention. I miss her.
Do any of these men look like the suspect that you saw outside your house before you left for work?
I'm not being funny, but they all really do look alike.
No rush, no rush. We stumbled across your phone this morning. Any idea how you might have misplaced it and when?
I can't even think. It's been a pretty rough 36 hours.
Yeah, of course. God, can't even imagine. It's just that in your statement you said that you didn't leave the shop and it was actually found behind your house on the night of the attack, so...
My statement? What are you trying to get at?
It's just a question. It's not like you're a suspect or anything.
A suspect?
No, not a suspect. Just a person of interest.
You're telling me you think I had something to do with killing Samina when you have a white guy on film!
What's happened, Mr. Hassan?
Mr. Hassan's phone was found by a witness outside the house. We're just asking how it got there.
Fuck's sake, this is... She don't deserve this. Look, I'm 17 months off an upgrade. So I dropped the phone in the skip behind the shop. And I was gonna say it got nicked so I could claim for a new one. Dad, I'm sorry.
Oh,
we're not done.
Your sergeant just declared my son a person of interest after questioning him without a solicitor. How is that going to play out?
I don't dispute asking how Hassan's phone got into the alley, but both of you circling round him when this man is our prime suspect. And who leaked this on Twitter?
Well, the reporters are asking about Nazi cake gate. Any comment?
Tell them it tasted so damn good, Mary Berry would have gobbled it down and done the goose step. Well, why camouflage a legitimate line of investigation?
We both thought they'd be oversensitive to formal questioning.
No, I thought, ma'am, that it was my fault.
What about Jimmy Webb?
Well, we didn't have enough to hold him. Ma'am, we've got sources covering all main fascist groups, including Jimmy's, and normally there'd be trophy chatter by now, but they're picking nothing up.
That's a first, ma'am. And I don't ever want to quote Jimmy Webb, but why would that lot bother with Mina when there's a much larger Asian family right next door?
Wrong cat flap.
Viv, what if it wasn't race hate? We just assumed it was because of the hair cut and the area. It could be a more personal motive, or...
Mina was a teaching assistant.
But that's how we've got on her. I mean, what if Mina wasn't even the target? What if it was Majid?
Find out more. Ask around, then quiz Majid and his dad. Make them understand our thinking. Sergeant, what are you going to do next time a top-notch constable offers you advice?
Take it, ma'am.
lost their plane.
Let's go.
I should have asked you straight up about your phone. I apologise. Oh, and this has been released as evidence. It was found in your bedroom. I thought you'd want it.
So, if it wasn't Race, what else is there?
We've been hearing Samina was quite a vocal feminist within the community. Oh. Any light you can shed on that for us?
Such as?
Come on, Dad, they mean the mosque. Samina made noise about women being allowed on the committee. Her and Dad would stay up all night talking about it. I'd wake up and they'd be having a massive row. I could never keep up, could I, Dad? She wanted to organise a demonstration. She didn't even have a chance to print off the leaflets. Sorry. I didn't
understand. Imam Hassan, do you think her stance might have been seen as controversial or inflammatory, even?
Maaf kar de, Samina.
It is so important that if anybody approaches you, anybody you haven't met before, in the street, in a shop, knocking on your front door, like whoever they are.
Can't we just tell our mates?
Let them finish, Teresa.
You must tell a responsible adult. Can't just be a mate. Has to be a parent or a guardian.
Is she your girlfriend?
It's Teresa, yeah?
I'm Teresa.
All right, Teresa. There is a man out there who wants girls like you, dead, and bobbing up and down in the river like apples. Now, I'm sorry, but we need you all to be scared of this guy. Yes.
We are.
You tease, you absolutely love it.
Hello, is that Stuart's dad?
T.
So what's going on between you and him? No, I'm just saying you must have a few years of prostate value left. There's no need to lean on the young man just yet. So I was just thinking, right, I've just got to break it to you very gently. Brilla!
Oh, Tegan!
Relax, relax. I'll put the phone down for us, anything.
Hello?
Shit.
Hello?
What was he having?
Two cokes then, please.
I want a pint.
No, I'm not having a pint.
Okay then, I will tell everyone that you took me in my party phone.
So you're saying the day that Lucy went missing, she was crying on the payphone to Patrick? How do you know it was Patrick?
Lucy was my friend. Captain. Brown bread. Brown bread. She meant brown beard. Shipperburn.
Patrick.
Just got off the phone from the bookies. Big tip.
Work tip, obviously.
Manager told us that last Thursday heard a big row in the bogs and saw Jimmy Webb chasing out an Asian guy saying he's going to kill him.
Oh, well, which Asian guy?
What did you think?
Oh, no. No. First you wreck our engagement, sticking him in prison. Then you smash our wedding. Fuck our honeymoon and be a clump out your spine.
Michelle. Threaten my boss one more time, you'll spend your honeymoon being finger-banged by women uglier than your mother-in-law.
Fucking pigs. Get me out of these handcuffs now. Jimmy! Jimmy!
We've witnesses saying you were arguing with Majid Hassan in a bookie's toilets 2 days after being released from prison. Why?
Stamp the bog out.
We know you threatened Majid's life. Week later, Taz gets torched. Simple maths, Jimmy.
All right. Okay. We help people out, yeah, you know, with cash flow sort of thing.
Yeah, I think you mean loan sharking.
I do it down the bookies because the in-laws might not like some of the clients we help out. I mean, this stuff isn't even me, but, you know, I fell in love. Her dad wouldn't accept me unless, you know, I converted.
When did you loan Majid money?
Michelle did. Said it was after 12k to pay off some gambling debts. Yeah, right. She only gave him 5, but then he kept palming her off. He wouldn't cough up. With interest, he owed about 20 by the time I came out. We had a wedding to pay for.
Did he pay you back? Where were you? You better start having flashbacks, or it'll be more than an extortion charge you're facing.
I was in the box at Half Moons. I got a hand job. I was twatted. It took a while.
Off who?
It was my stag night. Shit had been late since noon. She said her name was Marlene. She was black. Please don't tell Michelle.
Black? Bravo. Be more specific.
Well, there's a memory I've got, you know, she had long, dark hair, spandex, miniskirts, big tits. And then there's like a flash image, which has been sort of fucking with me a little bit, that she might have had some sort of deformity or something.
Deformity?
Jimmy, you're listening to me! Tell him to get me out of these handcuffs now!
A dick. Please don't tell Michelle.
Adam got that pint out of you then, did he?
Why didn't you tell us that Lucy called you the day she went missing?
She didn't.
Captain Brownbread. Okay. Where were you the night that Lucy went missing?
I love those kids.
Yeah? How much do you love them?
Don't be so disgusting, as if I'd ever even dreamed.
Dream of what? Heard you now? Lucy was raped.
I'll show you photos of her dead, cold, dug-up body. Just so you can see it before and after.
Now, I don't ever want to see them photos again, but if that's what it takes...
No, please, I didn't know. Not until you hurt those other two.
Who? Who, Patrick?
The boyfriend.
What? Wait, no,
no one we've spoken to has ever mentioned a boyfriend. Who?
The first day I met Lucy, she told me she loved me.
It got so bad she wouldn't even believe me when I told her that I'm gay. She was devastated. But then she told me that she found another bloke. Someone like me.
That made me nervous.
So I followed her. I saw him pick her up in a van.
What sort of van?
White Transit. He looked scared when he saw me.
You saw him? You saw him and you didn't stop him? He wasn't suspicious?
What do you think? But he got her back safe. She said he made her happy. I mean, who was I to judge?
She was in your care!
I couldn't face hurting her again.
So she rang me and...
stayed because she said he dumped her. She said she wanted to kill herself. I said I'd meet her at my local for a drink. She never showed.
And you didn't step forward with this when she went missing?
I was going to, but then they pulled her out of the river and I thought that she topped herself. But who'd feel better knowing that? How do you think they would feel if they knew I let one of them die? I couldn't. I'd lose my job.
Your job?
Job.
Lucy Cook, Jocelyn Wade. Very close to a third. You had days to come forward with this. And you knew he was still out there. You knew.
They're a good fit, but I said to get the black ones.
Shirt's okay though, yeah?
Yeah, shirt's fine. But Tess is right. Poor gap for another pair in black.
I've, had the cast off.
And you're here because...
I invited him, and he's staying for two, which is gonna be top.
Hey, come on, Tessa, let's go upstairs and tell Cathy the dinner's almost ready.
A knock first, yeah?
Would you rather have pissed off?
No. Not if you're being useful. But using Tess and Mum to get back over the map. Bit cheap.
They wanted me to meet Cathy, but...
Call 999. Check Tess and Pat. And Mum!
Tell her who I am, Kath.
Come forward again, what if that's what he tells?
Oh, please, I didn't know. Not until he heard those other two.
One sec.
No one we've spoken to has ever mentioned a boyfriend who...
Laurie, what does this look like to you?
Like every single night for the past couple of weeks. I'm not whining for a fuck here, Viv. I need a second opinion, and you promised me yours an hour ago.
Every night? And who was it who didn't bat an eyelid when you wanted to turn our tidy cellar into this stinking soundproof spaceship?
Well, he was working his tits off to prove that it was worth it. Are you going to pour or what? Okay, radio ad for the college. They want it street, catchy, unforgettable. Herpes, basically. Probably shite. Brace yourself. Ready?
Mm-hmm. Oh, Laurie, that's not shite. That is not shite, shite. Go on, can do it again, just one more time.
F sharp.
F sharp. Yeah?
F sharp. How do you know about F sharp?
Oh, I know F sharp.
It's better.
I think it's better. I like it.
I like it too, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Do you like this?
Savour the olives. But the Rioja doesn't stand a chance.
Isn't your girlfriend just full of surprises? How come Kathy's family never heard of you?
What, you've met her family, yeah?
Alfredo Delgani, 1 year out of your offenders.
Salfa?
Clearly not. Now, humour me. Where were you? The dates that Lucy Cook, Jocelyn Wade and your good lady were abducted.
Are you mad? What, me? Give us them dates.
March 10th for Lucy.
Sitting retakes. Yes, 6 A's, 3 B's, no C's. Check, next.
Jocelyn Wade, 2nd of September.
I was playing chess. And I won every single round to raise money for Spacky kids from my foster home. Well, you can check their phones, they loved it. I'm no suspect. I've worked in an office, you know. So fucked a lot of yous.
Okay.
Don't charge him, Dinah. I mean it, he'll fuck his life up again.
Go on. Go and see him. Can't blame her for not telling her family, Viv. They'd wreck her.
We've all put our neck in the noose for this kid. So there's no going back.
You've never taken anything at face value before. Kathy can't be the exception.
Now, Patrick Llewellyn's alibi has got some legs. He said he went to meet Lucy at the Blue Anchor pub the night she went missing. It's a gay pub. Patrick's a regular there. Now, look, here he is. 8:04 p.m, March 10th. Now, there's only one camera by the front door, but that same night, he went home with the landlord. Same again with the other girls.
If he is gay, it doesn't really fit with anything in the profile.
What, is there a rule book?
Yeah. Gay serial killers only ever target gay men. Dahmer, Nielsen.
I'm having him.
His alibi holds up. He knew about the van, which means he saw him. We don't want to alienate a star witness.
Star witness?
He didn't just turn a blind eye. Two girls died. God knows how many more. Are you saying it's not him?
No, of course I'm not. I'm saying it's unlikely.
No, Captain. My Captain.
I'm sorry. I'm so...
Scared of losing your job, Patrick? You'd better be waking up screaming, boy. I swear to God, you better be carrying this guilt like cancer till you croak. So, one question. Do we want the same thing, Patrick? Out loud, you streak of piss.
I want to help catch him.
I pray that's the only thing we'll ever have in common. Mr. Llewellyn.
Right. Good news is, we found Marlene. That deformity's a stonker. She was a giggle, actually. Check out that cleavage. Can't blame you. That Adam's apple, though. Can't quite get how you missed that. Your wife open-minded, Jimmy?
Please. Look, this is lifetime shit. Don't wreck it. Show it to me again. I'll tell you anything that I can.
Wait. Why would he get caught on camera unless he wanted to be seen? We know that twitch. Shit.
Gold stars, girls, for thinking outside the box. And for astonishing bigotry. A fucking mask.
Babe, ma'am, just play it out. Majid kept his shop door locked, so he could easily sneak out the back and peg it to the petrol station.
He makes damn sure he's seen getting the petrol, pours it in through the cat flap, and is in such a rush to get back, he drops his phone.
From a bank job, 4 years ago near Elderwood Avenue. You can get them for less than a grand.
What in there, Jonah?
How'd you know it was me, ma'am?
Got a very distinctive walk. Don't let anyone tell you different.
Cheers, Jonah. I owe you one.
That and the B.O. Motive.
Majid's paying off mega gambling debts, so he borrows money from Jimmy's wife. And he knows he hasn't got a prayer of paying it back.
When Jimmy gets out of prison, Majid knows he's on borrowed time. So, Majid sets fire to his wife for the life insurance and gets to keep the money by framing Jimmy.
And we link arms and yellow brick road it to McLaren's office and present him with this. Based on what? A tick.
I'm ever so disappointed, Majid. Why didn't you tell us that Jimmy had reason to set your house on fire?
Don't look at him. Look at me.
My dad can't know. You don't know what he's like.
You're so afraid of your dad that you'd let your wife's killer go free.
I'm sorry.
Sorry goes down much better for me with a chaser. Say 2 years for perverting the course of justice, and I'll ensure that you get the same room as Jimmy with the same view at the same time. Lovely. Ta.
Wait. I did it.
Come again.
There's a mask in a concrete installed biometric thumbprint safe hidden under a towel at my shop. You'll be needing this. But I want a word with my solicitor. In private.
This is you.
Doesn't look like we need his thumb. Put him up for trying.
Why the bullshit?
Any comments? Give me your wag! You're murdered! Martyred! In the name and fulfillment of Allah's holy word! Allah! Oh, Akbar! Allah! Oh, Akbar!
I'm trying to get it.
Husband to religious psychotic in under an hour. That's a bit rich even from you, Ashok.
4 weeks ago, his doctor put him on antidepressants because he said he was having suicidal thoughts.
Now, do you remember that mum from Hume smothered her kids and threw herself out the window?
Same drug, same dose. You calling in a psychiatric report, or am I?
Tensions are running high in North Manchester today amidst escalating protests and attacks from all sides, with several casualties already reported.
Get back to your desks.
Ma'am, the street fight on Poppyfield Road between a gang of Asians and the BDAF. Neighbourhood watch got stuck in, so it's got messy.
Thanks, God.
And McLaren's on the warpath, wants to know if you've saved him a piece of that cake.
Do you think you could text me this shit?
Majid Hassan's brilliantly adapted to everything we've thrown at him. Framing Jimmy failed, and now he's a mad jihadi.
That scumbag deserves a life for what he's done, not 7 months in the puzzle factory.
Fuck. What do you suggest?
We thump this twat right back in his box with the right motive, and we get that out there fast, before anybody else gets hurt.
Sounds lovely. How?
Well, Samina's got to have known her husband's death was spiralling out of control, so she must have told someone.
When you were with Majid, his dad was just staring at Samina's necklace, and he said something in Urdu, but I tried to Google translate it, but I can just remember it phonetically.
Muf kuna Samina marim marishuka.
Something, something, Samina, something.
With conviction, Joy.
Muf kuna Samina marim marishuka.
Do you have a club card? Maf kuna Samina marim marishuka. It means forgive me, Samina, my darling. Why didn't you ask me in the first place, Sarge?
I couldn't work out if it was racist or not.
Leave me alone.
Sir, just one question. Your son saying he killed Samina in God's name. His solicitor's claiming he's crazy. Do you honestly believe either? Lads that you've known since they were born are a baseball bat away from joining your son in jail or hospital. Right now, you're either this community's imam or you're that boy's father. You can't be both. Samina begged the imam to grant her a divorce 5 weeks before the fire, but the imam wouldn't grant it. She'd found out Majid had remortgaged the house to pay his gambling debts and put a stop to it.
I want a full-blown confession from Majid. On tape, both of you.
No. Majid already thinks I'm a screw-up. It should be me. Just me. I know I can trip him up, ma'am. It shouldn't have to be a question.
So, Majid,
you're mentally ill.
No, thank God I'm not. I heard the voices of martyrs on my shoulders, and they were bidding me the courage of a child of Allah. You proud, Dad?
Oh, he's far from proud, Majid. And if you are hoping to pin your sudden jihadist urges on meds, it won't work. Your doctor's given me the dates he started taking them. Here. Now, how come, before you started taking the medication, your wife's life insurance policy was signed while she was on a school trip at Euro Disney?
You know what Allah just whispered to me? How fat must your legs look without heels?
Answer the question.
How did your wife sign the life insurance
when she wasn't even in the country? If you really are
a jihadist, don't you think we would have found some hardcore stuff
hanging about? Extremist websites on your phone?
Allah compels me, not YouTube. Step outside, sister, see the glory the blood of my wife has already sown.
In 50 years, your grandchildren will be Muslim.
May I suggest that we stop wasting valuable time
and get my client into a psychiatric facility.
Save him.
For his own safety.
Is that a slim fit Armani shirt?
How much was that?
100. 150.
Try 200, love.
It's just that we hauled in a batch of those last week, selling two for a tenner down the market. Saw you coming a mile off.
Still, 200 quid. Did Samina
have to buy it for you?
No.
No, but she had to buy you your skinhead mask, didn't she? Look, it says here on her credit card statement, look, spending your wife's cash on the mask that you were going to murder in, that is top five.
She didn't know I was going to. She bought it herself for fun.
Come on, Jade. You took out that credit card behind her back because you couldn't scrape up the cash.
Love you. Say, God.
English, Mr. Hassan.
Said I'm going to cut your head off.
I thought you'd be used to answering to women by now.
By all accounts, it's your wife that held the purse strings.
She didn't.
Working day and night, coming home, leaving your balls by the front door, she'll chop them off, am I right?
Oh, you think I'd kill my wife for money?
Your dad does. You must have been so desperate. I get it. Your whole life, you felt like an embarrassment to others, but most of all to yourself.
Shit.
Look at that! Ripped off like toilet paper. Samina probably never laughed at you to your face, but on behalf of a woman who sounds like a cracking good bird, let me!
The only thing that bitch was good for was catching hands!
So you did kill her for the money?
Fucking right, I did! Dad didn't arrange a marriage for me, he just handpicked the daughter he never had.
And I never once put a foot wrong, and she
still had his hair more than me!
Majid, you just drop-kicked yourself into a life sentence. Don't bother having the last word.
And you're such a hurry fucking gone from me! Fucking worm!
Fuck off!
Consider that leaked.
Take a bow, lady. Take a bow.
No. These are on me.
Oh, thanks, man.
Do I pick him or do I pick him?
You are not so sulky about that call I made to old man yet.
It was a joke. What's going on between you two anyway?
Okay, what was it? Did he finger when you were little or something? Am I right?
Tegan, meet my old man.
Mr. O'Connell.
I am so sorry about what happened on the phone and about the thing-ring thing just then. Did you hear that?
Off my tits off. Name's Jock, by the way. We're on Brandy's. You?
Yes, please. Doubles.
Hey, pal, I'm not in this.
I'm not having it, right? I'm not having this anymore. It's just one of
my material. Okay, thank you.
I've been fiddled with. Where are you going now? I'm trying to make a call.
Clive, you best tell your vocab around me right now, because I'm about 2 seconds away from shoving a taser up your arse and pumping you so full of volts you'll feel like you've been fisted by a pylon. Now go and sit down.
You all right, sir?
She's missing.
All right? Thanks,
Mr. You're very welcome. Okay?
What else is she keeping quiet?
Did you mention having a boyfriend?
Someone was very keen.
We're doing everything we can to get her back.
I told her to get out there. Be stupid and normal like everyone else.
Please.
Honey, get the woman!
Nowhere to run, nowhere to hide.
What's the crime?
It only does people a favour.
Definitely something rotten in the state of Primark.
Top Cop, James McAvoy versus Mark Strong, Alpha Male season. The thriller, Welcome to the Punch, on Film 4 Plus One right now. But coming up, no work, no money, and nowhere to go. Could it be a recipe for mischief? Benefit Street, next.